It's pie in the sky stuff, literally. Everything from food to coffee, even medicine, dropped at your door from above. But drones are also delivering drama to some suburbs and a lot of noise.
If you get too many of them in the sky, it's eventually there is going to be a problem. It's like a sore that won't heal.
For Dan Ling, there's nothing better than soaking up the serenity in his own slice of paradise. But now it's under threat once again.
I think it can't be a good thing.
You might remember this outspoken retiree, a current affair first speaking to Dan last year at his home in Logan, south of Brisbane.
Here's another one now as we speak. I can hear it. There we are. There's two in a row. Look at that. There's eight. Eight in an hour.
The store-to-door delivery company is called Wing. The drones fly everything from food and drinks to pharmaceuticals and even hardware. It's been operating out of locations around Australia for the last 4 years and dividing residents ever since.
Meat pie, they do like toothpaste. You can order a pancake mix, so you get that with some syrup. It's just like, why not, you know?
The convenience fueling an addiction for some of Dan's neighbours, like Dale Carter.
So yeah, here it comes now, actually.
It would be akin to having permanent tinnitus listening to these things.
Last year, the popularity of the service was at its peak. Delivery was free, with users only paying for the cost of the product.
So people were just buying cans of Coke and soft drinks and meat pies and whatever and getting it for free.
Since our last story went to air, Wing started charging an undisclosed delivery fee, and Dan says it's caused some turbulence for the company.
It promptly stopped. Within a fortnight, it was gone. It was really good. I thought, mission accomplished.
Now, Wing has announced it's expanding operations beyond the rooftop of Browns Plains Grand Plaza.
In the coming days, we'll be launching from Hyperdome, which is a very busy and popular shopping centre in Logan City. We know there's a lot of traffic here. It's one of the fastest growing areas in terms of residential across the entire country.
Wing's head of Australian public policy, Jesse Suskin.
We'll be serving over 17 suburbs from this centre right here.
I thought, oh, here we go again. They're trying to fly in under the radar and annoy the neighbourhood, not just here, but all over Logan.
18 additional drones will be joining the fleet, taking off from Wing's latest launch pad here in Logan. These drones have been modified to be 50% quieter than the original model, and since they've been flying from Browns Plains, there's been one noise complaint this year.
We average 43 decibels, which means practically if you're inside your house, it's not likely you would actually hear the drone flying over it. You know, a car driving by would be somewhere anywhere between 60 to 65 decibels.
Retail expert Professor Gary Mortimer.
I think as the cost of the drone comes down and people become more confident in using that type of service, we'll see more of it happen.
We fly at 110 kilometres per hour, so we can deliver that item in just a few minutes.
Still cold.
I like the idea of being able to get groceries and things into the backyard.
I work in the disability field, so sometimes I actually can't leave the home, and it's like, I would just like a bubble tea or just something like that.
We will have a few new sites to announce pretty soon.
When I initially first saw it, I was intrigued. I thought, oh, that's interesting, but it wears pretty thin after a while. But it's a business model that is doomed to fail, as far as I'm concerned. It really is.